Okay, so now let's do that and start our demodulation. So let's separate this properly from our modulation part, that we know that we're doing something separately. So the first step is rectify. Rectify. So what we need to do here is very simple. So we're just running a loop from the first to the last sample of our whole AM signal. And so if the AM signal of AII is greater than zero, we just leave it as it is and put this into another variable called rectified and just leave it as an AM signal. And otherwise we just rectified, we just setting the rectified to zero. So this gives us here the end, and then also here the end of our for loop. So with that, hopefully we have a rectified signal in the variable rectified. So let's see if we run that and do plot rectified, and we bring the plot window up. So we see a rectified signal. Okay, so now the next step was or is to create our low pass filter. So let's do that. So now the next step is low pass. So the low pass, we need to create our FIR filter or our low pass filter. And yeah, some useful values are these ones here. These are 100 taps, and let's say that's a cutoff frequency of 0.15. Okay, so then let's filter this. So so we've got the rectified here. So let's call this here low pass. Demodulated, and we just write filter. And the syntax is first the coefficient b, and the 1, and then we just put the rectified in here. And so let's save that. Let's just see if we're running AM, if we are getting a demodulated signal. Okay, so that's looking good. So we see that. So now instead of the, when we compare this with the rectified, so now we have a low pass filtered version here. And so obviously, if you're putting a threshold in there, for example at 0.2 or 0.1, then we should be able to distinguish between our zeros and ones, and are able to piece together our Pac-Man. So now what I've kept here on the left is our demodulated signal. So that's our modulated signal. And so if I draw a cartoon version of this here, so we have something like that, and so this might be t, our interval here, and so within this interval, then we have here 1, that's a 0, that's a 1, that's a 1 again. And so what we need to do is, so we need to ideally obviously sample here at these moments here. So we sample here at these points, and then we are reconstructing our image here. So we sample at intervals of t. So ideally right in the middle here. So let's do that. Let's bring back octave here and so go back to the editor. So I've already added this code here just to speed things up a bit, that we're defining a time t sample here. So this time t sample, this defines when we are looking here at this data here at this moment. So bring octave back in. And so this t sample, and then obviously if t sample here is greater than 0.2, then we have a 1, and otherwise it's a 0. And then we are just putting this into our image here and doing the index, the x and y indices here, that we're getting a 2D image back out there again. Okay, so let's run that. Let's see if we're getting our Pac-Man back. So AM, and so there's the image show and rec image, and let's have a look at our Pac-Man here. Okay, so that doesn't look like the Pac-Man we had before. So we need to fix that, and the question is why do we see the, that this Pac-Man is somewhat like shifted. So it's, we see here there's a certain delay here at the beginning, and then the whole image is shifted. So why has this happened here? And the question is obviously, where does this shift actually happening? So where is the shift or delay introduced in this program? That's an N introduced. And the solution is, it's introduced by the filter. The filter is to blame. So let's look at the code. Where do we have this problem here? So here, this filter operation introduces a delay, and this delay is exactly half of these samples here, plus the group delay of the filter. So it's 100, it's 50 plus a group delay. So we could just introduce here, just as a first guess without knowing the group delay, but it won't be very long. So we could just add 50 plus here and save that and run our program again. So now we are getting a problem that our index runs, that we're running out of the index here, because now our t sample here goes beyond the length of our LP demod here. Yeah. So what we need to do is, we just need to essentially expand this a bit. So we need to have our signal running a bit longer. So in order to do this, we could essentially just steal this loop here and create a bit of dummy data at the end. So let's see if this works now. Oops, line 84, something wrong. Oh yeah, I've forgotten the end. So now this works. So let's see. We're going back to the history here, and let's see if we are now getting our Pac-Man back. Yeah, and there we go. So the Pac-Man is reconstructed in its full beauty. And with that, so we have concluded the AM modulation and AM demodulation, and also seen how this works in a MATLAB program.